Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Praveen Dharmale. I am working in Abu Dhabi, Ragnarok Offshore, as a senior electrical engineer. And I am pursuing this PhD from Kalinga University in electrical engineering. Now, my paper presentation topic is utilizing PSO method for calculating both limit of power system. Okay. Now, we will go through the abstract of the paper and different inertia weight technical terms, methodology. Then we are using fast voltage stability index, particle swarm optimization method. This is the methodology we will do and how it is going to be implemented on the different power system. We'll have a result and a discussion session, and in the end, we will conclude the session. Okay, now, why did I choose this voltage limit using PSO method? As a layman term, you can see that you have various electrical appliances in your house, in your home. It can be anything. You have a ceiling fan, you have an incandescent lamp, you have a television, and it is all having the voltages. Okay, like in the domestic application, you have a 220 volt, which is coming into your house. Now imagine that over a period of time, you are increasing from the lamps or television sets or the ceiling fans. The load will continue to be increased. Eventually, what will happen at some point of time, your fuse will be blown off. Why it will be blown off? You are not having a common voltage, which used to be, which is required to run your appliances. Okay, now imagine it's a big tree, industrial application. The power is flowing in a big quantity. Now, where I'm coming from, Edna offshore, there I work. Okay, now. Yeah. Okay, now I'm coming from Edna offshore. Now, demand is 1 million barrel per day. Okay, I'm audible now. So, demand is 1 million barrel per day. And cost of oil today is how much? It's hovering around $97 to $100. So imagine that we have a plant with a power generation capacity of 80 megawatt, and suddenly due to voltages or demand, it collapses. Grid collapses, production loss. Now multiply this figure, 1 million barrel multiplied by $100 million is the loss. Okay, it's just an example. Okay, so how do we overcome it? We have different applications, approaches, and calculations. Okay, how to avoid this power collapse in the grid. Okay, now, blackout should be avoided at all costs, especially in the industrial settings where losses can occur. The goal of this study is to determine the maximum load capacity of the each bus before it collapses. Next. 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 Yeah, now you can see this is the figure. Now, this is typical 50 MVA transformer. You can see the white box. Okay, what is this, the purpose of this white box? It is used to regulate the voltage. For example, if the power demand is very huge, okay, and you want to control the voltage from plus or minus 5% to maintain the stability on the grid, we use this. Okay, this is just for illustration purpose. Now, this is the different inertia weight strategies. Yeah. Now, these are the different inertia weight strategies for the particle swarm optimization method, which uses algorithm in the background for the application. Now, experiment shows that inertia weights ranging from 0.9 to 0.4 produce outstanding results. It was tried successfully on the urban planning challenge. What does it mean? Urban planning challenge means the infrastructure development. No? They will forecast what will be the power demand in next 5 years, next 20 years, next 25 years. Okay, and what are the challenges they will foresee? For a period of time, there will be need to improve the infrastructure. Okay, and with the new technologies, artificial intelligence, we can do that. Next slide, please. Now, IEEE, they came up with a typical 6-bus and 30-bus system. Okay, now IEEE bus system is used in this project because the IEEE bus system's power flow data is accurate. It is utilized as a test bus. Now in this figure, you can see the 6-bus system And we have an infinite generation at the each bus. Consider this G symbol, which is used here. You can see this is a generator. It symbolizes generator. And all these vertical lines and horizontal lines, these are all interconnected. This, you can say that these are the power cables or transmission lines. It is typical system. Next slide, please. Yeah, now this is a 30 bus system. You can see the various generations of voltages at various levels. And these are all interconnected. It is like a fan. I'll go to the. So this particle storm optimization is a reversionary method which is used in this study. So in IEEE 6 bus system and 30 bus system, we are used ETAP, MATLAB software. These are all running in the background. Okay, these are all application software. How we overcome? We input this data into the system and it will give you the maximum capacity of the bus which we need. Now this is the iterations matter, iteration 0 and iteration 1 with the particle swarm. You can see that here all these particles are haphazardly overcome. When we use the iteration method with particle swarm for a period of time, it will iterate, and then it will give you the best optimal result. Okay, this is the flowchart which is used in the algorithms. Now, this is the result, what we come. Now, you can see that the earlier, which I showed you, the 6 bus system. Can you go to the next slide? This is the final result when we input all these parameters into the 6 bus system. You can see the bus numbers, what is the load in megawatt and what is the stability index we are getting. Now at bus number 3, you can see the load is maximum 136 megawatt and this stability index is 0.9. Means this is the strongest bus. And at bus number 5, that is the weakest bus. Okay, and same is depicted to the bar chart. Next slide, please. Next slide. Okay, I'll jump to the conclusion. Now, despite being a part of system, each bus has its own load restriction. The stability index value is the same way. The maximum load limit is not always determined by the greatest FPSI value. Buses with an FPSI rating close to 1 are considered weak. With FPSI value, the fast voltage stability index ranging from 0.89 to 0.98 respectively, bus 3 and bus 15 are the weakest bus in the 6% 30 bus system. And as I said earlier, the maximum limit for the 6 bus system is 136 megawatt. Okay, so this approach with the particle swarm optimization with the simulation annealing, this is the fast moving technology. And nowadays, in all the power system software, this technology is being used to determine so that the grids are stable, voltage is stable, everything is stable. I will conclude my statement with the statement from Energy Ministry of UAE. His Highness Dr. Sultan Al Jaber. His statement is, nowadays, world needs maximum energy with minimum emissions. Okay, so we have to work upon it continuously to maximize our productivity, maximum efficiency, reliability, focus on the other technologies where we can get this energy with less emissions. Okay, thank you very much. Any questions?
Thank you, sir. For your conversation, thank you for the women entrepreneurship in India, building their capabilities. Over to you, ma'am.
Thank you so much.